I am still Sam Walton.
Proper job first.
No, please.
I'm Sam Warburton, former Cardiff Blues, Wales, British and Irish Lions rugby player.
I'm Kevin Jones. I'm managing director for Panasonic Mobile Solutions Business Division in Europe and avid rugby fan.
So I play back row, which you've got to be quite good at a bit. You've got to do a bit of everything when you're back row. So if I was speaking to a young back row player, I'd say, okay, well, they say, well, how do you get better? What can I do? I say, okay. I say, well, what are your strengths and weaknesses? And then most people straight away go, I can't do this and I can't do that. And I say, yeah, but what can you do? What are you best at? What's the one thing that you're better than everyone else at, or that you can be better than everyone else at? But people don't focus on that. A lot of people focus on what they can't do. So in any line of work, whatever it is, we can't do this, we can't do that, and they can. But I say, yeah, but what are you good at? Because whatever you're good at, you need to make sure you keep practicing that as hard as the stuff, if not harder than the stuff you're not good at, because you need to remain the best at that. And some people might naturally be very good at something. They might say, I'm going to talk about it in layman's terms, but somebody might be good in attack, for example, naturally, but they're not very good in defense, and they spend all their time practicing defense. If you do that for a long period of time, that ends up going like this. Your attack comes down and your defense goes up. But what you should really be doing is, I always say, you need a point of difference. What is your X factor that separates you from the rest of the competition? Whatever that is, you need to develop everything else, but that point of difference, that X factor, needs to remain the best. So for me, I felt I was good at something. I practiced that, what I was good at, harder than all the stuff that I wasn't as good at, because I knew I had to stay the best at that.
I totally agree with you. And you know, in Panasonic, as most businesses, we use if you're a leader, you'll get an annual 360 feedback process. You can nominate 20 peers or team members, inside or outside, it doesn't matter. And they can give some anonymous feedback around Panasonic global leadership competencies and so forth, yeah. And you get that feedback. And it's really, really interesting because, okay, things, you know, you think, oh yeah, I know I'm good at that, so I've got a 5 on those things. But the most beneficial thing is what we call positive and negative blind spots. So I've ranked myself, because I'm part of that process, so I've ranked myself a 5, let's say, on, you know, being authentic. But my team or everybody has ranked you as a 2. Or I've ranked myself as a 2 and they've ranked you as a 5. And then, you know, having the opportunity then to explore that with a coach and also with your team to say, okay, well, this is why I think I'm this. And sometimes there's a communication thing, and sometimes actually go back to stopping the complacency. You know, you've got a little bit carried away there, and they're bringing you back to ground. And maybe in this one, like you said, okay, that is a strength for me, but I don't recognize it.
Well, that's called imposter syndrome, I think, isn't it? You know, so a lot of people suffer with that. They don't think they're good enough to be something, but they actually are. And it takes someone to drag that out of a lot of people, you know? I'd rather it be that way than the other way, where they sort of humble and they don't think they're good enough. But some people are probably, if they're watching or whatever, they're probably leaders without even knowing they are. They're doing all the daily traits that is required, but it does, and I think that's a good exercise. It might take someone to make them realize that and drag it out of them and give them that confidence to take that next step forward and be a leader.
But where we started was about, you know, leadership. From my standpoint was, you know, how do you get people to achieve the impossible? How do you get them to do more than what they ever thought they could achieve, you know, and deliver on those things? And that's your job as a coach. And I think, you know, an important part of being a leader, whether you're the captain of the team, is also to build coaching, and that's spend time with your team members, having one-to-ones, having some open discussion over a coffee or a beer, you know, or over a bite to eat, whatever the case may be, and giving them, creating an environment where they're not afraid to discuss things, you know, they solicit your input, and create an environment for them to flourish. Yeah. And I think that's also very important, because you take, otherwise, they start, they're back to the worrier, not warrior mode, because they're thinking, okay, what am I weak at, because I'm going to fail here. And as you said, if all of a sudden you know, if you're really good at attack, not so good at defense, okay, everybody needs to be able to defend and everybody's, before, if you change that balance, then they take a negative approach to the game as opposed to a positive approach to the game, and business is no different.
Yeah.